Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. This is my website studysalesforce.com. So here you can find all the Salesforce related videos, links together on single platform. So you can visit that. In this video, I'm going to discuss and demonstrate about how you can use before update and after update in Apex Trigger. So in my previous video, I demonstrated you about before insert and before insert and after insert. So here in this video, these are two scenarios. Those are for before update and after update. So first take a look on before update. So here the scenario is, if account phone is updated, then put update message in description. So whenever account record on account record, if you are updating the phone number, so we need to put a message in the description field that your phone number is updated, right? So this we want to perform in before update. So as you saw in my previous video, when we used in before insert, so this was the method update rating, and I defined that method in Apex Trigger Handler. So here you saw whenever we perform before insert, so we don't require any DML operation. So same is with before update. So when we will be implementing before update method, so we don't want to write any DML separately. So because record is not saved, so before saving the record, if you are applying before insert or before update, then your field can be updated automatically. So now I'm going to update the trigger. So here I'm writing one more block, that is if trigger dot is update, right? And inside this block I will be checking whether it is before or is after, and here I need to use these events. So before update, so after update, right? And I'm just copying this block and pasting it here. So trigger dot is before, trigger dot is after. So here I'm going to call a method as update phone description. And here I'm going to write update related opportunity phone. So that is our another scenario, that is for after update. So if account phone is updated, then populate that on all related opportunities. So that I am going to demo you later on. So first we will be discussing about this update phone description. So right now here you can see two error messages are available because these methods are not defined. So now I am moving to a trigger handler. So here I am going to define the methods. So public static void. So name of the method is update phone description. So I'm pasting this, then list of account, new list. And one more thing that we are going to use here, that is additional parameter trigger dot old map. So in the introductory video related to trigger, I told you like we have these two context variable, trigger dot new, that is having new list that you have updated, and the existing records information will be available in the old map along with the ID, right? So we need to check new state of phone field as well as its existing state, right? And then only we will be updating the description, because there may be chances like you are updating the account record and you didn't change phone. So if phone is not changed, phone is not updated, so we don't want to execute this method, right? So that's why we are going to compare new list phone value and old map phone value. If both are unequal, then only this trigger definition will be executed. So here I'm going to use map of ID account and naming it as old map, right? So this is the method where I need to implement the logic. So now I am going to implement a loop. So loop will be for account ACC new list, right? Now inside this new list, I'm going to apply if condition. So if old map is not equals to null, so this will be first condition. If old map is not null, it means you are performing update operation, right? Then we need to compare new phone value with old. So what you can write, acc.phone not equals to. So acc is the variable that we are going to use in this loop, which is having new list information one by one. So let's say in new list, you have five records. So all record one by one will be available into this acc. So if acc.phone, that is the new state of the phone, is not equals to, now we need to check the old state. So what we can do, old map dot get, then acc.id. So whenever you are using map to retrieve the value, we need get method, and get requires a key. So this is the key that we are passing acc.id, and get will be returning the value. And here you can see value is account. You can see here value is complete account record, but we need only phone field. So I am writing phone here. So this is the complete if. If old map is not equals to null, it means you are updating the record. And if acc.phone, this is the new state of the phone that you updated, and this will be having the existing value. So if both are unequal, it means on the account record, you updated the phone field. So here I'm writing acc.description equals to phone is modified on account, right? And I need to enclose it in single quotes. So this way I implemented this before update trigger, and the method is update phone description. So whenever I will be updating the phone field on the account, so this method will be executed with the help of trigger. So now I'm saving this. So here you will see automatically this error will be gone at line number 11, right? So I'm saving this as well. So line number 13 will still show error because this method is not defined yet. So I'm just commenting this one because right now we are going to test the before update thing. So again, I'm saving this. So now all the errors will be gone. So this is the time to check account record. So I'm opening one account record. Let's say test trigger 5, moving to details. And here you can see phone is not available, blank, description is also blank. Now I'm updating phone value. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and I'm clicking on save. So here you can see phone is modified on account. So this way you saw whenever I updated phone field, so description is updated automatically, right? Now let me open any another record. Let's say test trigger 4. So this is another one. Here phone is blank, and description you can see it is also blank. And I'm just updating type. Let's say installation partner. So as I updated type, so trigger didn't work, update trigger didn't work because we are not updating the phone field. So you can see description is still blank. So this way, this condition is very important. Whenever you are implementing before update, or maybe after update. So you need to check whether specific fields are modified or not. Then only you can apply the logic. Otherwise, what will happen if we remove this thing? If we remove this thing, so what will happen? Whatever field you are changing or updating, this trigger will be updating description always, right? So to restrict that updation, whenever any other field is also updated, so we need to put this condition. So I hope this way you understood the working of before update. And here you can see before insert is also available. So here only new list is available, and we are updating the rating field. And in before update, we are updating the description. And in both the scenarios, we are not performing any other DML like insert or update. So this is the only case that is available in before insert and before update, because in that case, the trigger.new that we pass, the trigger.new that we pass in case of before insert or before update is editable. So we are passing trigger.new into this new list, and through this new list, we are fetching the values in ACC and we are updating the ACC. So basically, internally, these are connected with referencing. So if you are updating ACC, it means trigger.new is automatically updating, right? So in case of before trigger, this trigger.new is editable. So that's why we don't require any additional DML. So I hope you understood the working of before update. Now this is the time for after update. So in case of after trigger, so after trigger fires when your record is saved in the database. But remember one thing, it is not committed yet, because your record is saved, then after triggers will work, and then some more operations will be executed, and then your record is actually committed in the database, right? So whenever any failure occurs, so a whole process is rolled back automatically, right? So remember one thing, whenever your record is saved, after that, after trigger works, and before that, before trigger works. So now in case of after update, we will be requiring DML operations so that we can update the opportunities. So now whenever phone is updated, we want to populate that on opportunities as well. So moving to our logic. So let me go here. So I'm just checking my process builders. Okay, so here you can see on account, we have two processes, so both are inactive. So yeah, no problem. So now we can work. So why I checked, because in my earlier process builder demo, I created one process builder that automatically updates account, phone, or any other field to opportunities. So that's why I confirmed that. So now I'm going to uncomment this, and here also I'm going to pass trigger.oldMap, right? So this method I need to define now in trigger handler. So I'm moving to trigger handler. And here I'm going to write public static void, pasting the method name and whatever I passed in this update. So I'm going to use this here as well. And here I'm going to write the definition. So now what we need to do whenever account phone is updated, we need to update the related opportunities as well, right? So I'm going to iterate a loop. And before that, I'm going to create a map of ID. And let's say account. So account ID to account map equals to new map of ID comma account, right? Now while iterating this loop, what I'm going to do, so first let me write this thing. So new list, right? Now I'm going to check that condition. So inside this loop, I'm going to check this condition. And if old map is not null and account phone, that is new list value, and the old map is fetching the existing one, if they are unequal, it means phone is updated. So in that case, I'm going to put the values in this map. So in this map, what I'm going to do, I'm basically putting ACC.id, it means account ID, and account record completely. So I'm just filtering those records where phone field is modified. So it may happen like from data loader, you are updating various records, and only in few records phone field is modified. So we are just filtering those records only, right? So this way, this map will be having ID, account ID and account record for those records where phone field is modified. So that information is available into this map. Now we need to fetch the related opportunity that we want to update, right? So here I'm going to create one list. So it will be list of opportunity. So opportunity list equals to new list of opportunity, right? So now what I'm going to do, I'm going to use this opportunity list equals to, then select ID, phone from opportunity where, so on opportunity we have one field that is account ID, right? So account ID in, now I'm going to use this map dot key set. So whenever we use this method key set, so it automatically generates a set of keys. Those are available in the map. So that set will be available here, and through in we can check a particular account ID in that set. So if on a particular opportunity, the account ID is available in this set, so those are opportunities will be available into this OPP list, right? So it is showing one error. Why so? Because I mentioned this spelling as incorrect. So now this error will be gone, right? Now we can iterate one more loop. So for opportunity OPP, and this OPP list we can mention here, right? So what we can do, we can put this complete query here as well, in place of OPP list. So what I'm going to do, I'm using this here, right? So all the opportunity records will be queried where account ID in this key set. So one by one OPP will be available here. And now we need to remove this thing as well. And I'm renaming it as opportunities to be updated. So those opportunities which we are going to update, their information will be available into this list. Now I'm going to check if condition. So you can see opportunity will be available here. So what I'm going to do now, through this opportunity, I'm going to fetch account ID. So, and then account ID, I'm going to check in this map. And if that account ID is available in this map, then I'm going to fetch the phone value from this ACC, or the value that is available in the map. So first of all, I'm going to use this dot contains key. So through contains key, we can check whether a particular key is available in the map or not. And key will be OPP dot account ID, right? So the opportunity that we queried, if its account ID is available in that map, it means this opportunity is somewhere related to the account that is available in that map. So now we can update this. So here I need to create one more opportunity instance. So opportunity OPPOR equals to new opportunity. So this I created. Now if that key is already there, so what I'm going to do, opportunity.id equals to opp.id and oppor dot, okay, so let me check the phone field that we are going to use on opportunity. Okay, so we are going to use this phone that name is account phone on opportunity. So here I'm going to use that field. So it is a custom field. And here, here I need to populate the phone number from the account. So now I'm going to use this map.get. Now I need to pass the key. So key will be this. And get method will receive the value. So value, you can see the complete account record is. So dot, and you can write phone. Right, so through that complete account record, you just want to fetch the phone. So phone will be stored in this, and this is created now. So if this condition will be true, then only we want to add this opportunity into the list. So list we created here. So if it is true, then you can write dot add and OPPOR, right? So after completion of this loop, whenever this if condition will be true, so updated opportunities will be available into this list. Now, after completion of this loop, what you can do? Here also opportunity spelling is incorrect. Right. So after completion of this loop, you need to check if not, then opportunity to be updated, this list is empty. If it is not empty, then you can apply update and then list of name. So all those opportunity records will be updated where the related account phone is updated. So this way, now I'm going to save this. Okay, so it is showing two errors. Okay, let me search for this. Account ID is correct. Why it is showing error? Select ID phone from opportunity where account ID in. Let me see the error again. Okay. Got it. So this phone field is showing the error because I need to use this phone. Now I'm saving this and saving this. So now you can see both are error free because no star is available and no error message is available in this problem tab. So this way, now we are ready to execute this, right? So when I will be updating phone on account, so you will see both will execute. This will also execute because this will be updating description field on the phone, and this second method will be updating the related opportunities, this phone field. So moving to account, so let's check this one. So on related, we need to check whether opportunity is available or not. So yeah, it is having one related opportunity, right? So let me create one more. So I'm creating one more opportunity on this test trigger 5. So test trigger 5-2. So this is another one. I'm putting close date, stage, name I already provided. So now you can see two opportunities are available, right? Now I'm moving to details. So on this, this phone is already available 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So let's move to related and I'm opening these two opportunities as well, so that we can check what is the existing value here. So if I move to details, so here you can see account phone is blank. And for this one, account phone is also blank. Now I'm going to update account phone here. So right now it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I am writing 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 and clicking on save. So it is showing. Okay, so now here you can see if something is incorrect in your trigger. So this kind of error will be available. So it is showing account trigger. So error is on account trigger, execution of after update. So for after update, it is showing error caused by system.s object exception. S object row was retrieved via SOQL without querying the requested field. And the field is opportunity.accountid. So it is further showing class.accountTriggerHandler update related opportunity phone, line 11, column 1, and for account trigger, line 13 and column 1. So from account trigger, so if we move to account trigger, so here you can see on line number 13, we are calling this method. And if we move to account trigger handler, so on line number 51, so on line number 51, so here it is saying we are using this account ID, but we are not querying it. So if you are using a particular field for any process, so you need to query it in SOQL, right? So that's why it is showing the error. So as it is having error, it means before operation was not completed. So it will be rollback as error is available in after update. So now if I click on save, so you will see no error will come. Record will be saved successfully. So here you can see phone is modified on account, message is available, and I am refreshing this opportunity as well. So we will see 654321. This phone value will be available on both the opportunity records that are related to account. Here you can see. So we are on opportunity, that is test trigger 5-2. And here you can see account phone is available. If we move here, so here also you can see in details, this account phone is available. Now, if you again modify this, let's say we are adding this value, click on save. So automatically the related phone will be updated. Related opportunities phone will be updated. And if you modify any other field except phone, so this updation won't be working because we already filtered the records where phone is updated, then only related opportunities should be queried. So here if I see on the details, so you will see, yeah, so it is updated automatically. And here also you can see the details. Yeah, 111 is added 4 times at the end. Now if I modify any other thing, let's say I am modifying type, clicking on save. So if I refresh the opportunity, both the opportunities, so you will see the phone field won't be affected. It will be having the same value, right? So this way, I hope you understood how we can use before update and after update. So I showed you all the things together as well. So this block is for insert, before insert, after insert, and this block is for before update and after update. And accordingly, you can call the methods. This may also happen like for before insert, you have multiple methods. So here you can call any number of methods. Right, so this way you can create the blocks and you can call any number of methods. And in the trigger handler, you can write the proper definitions, whatever operation you want to perform. So this we implemented in this video for updating account description if phone is updated. And here you can see this is another method that we implemented, which is updating related opportunities phone if a parent account phone is updated. And this way we are filtering those accounts for which we want to query the related opportunities. So I hope you understood whatever I tried to demonstrate in this video. So I hope now after watching this video, you are familiar with before update and after update thing. So also you notice that in before update, we don't write any DML like insert update, but in case of after update, we need to write insert update or whatever DML on same record or any related record, we can do that. So this is the basic difference between them. And in case of before update and after update, we also pass old map, trigger.old map. But in case of before insert and after insert, we only use trigger.new because in case of insertion, existing state is not available. But in case of update, existing as well as new state of record will be available. So for comparison purpose, we can use both trigger.new and trigger.oldmap in case of update triggers. So in my another videos, those will be available after this. I will be demonstrating delete triggers, undelete triggers. Then I will be implementing all before triggers, like before insert, before update, before delete in single video. And after insert, after update, and after delete in single video. So this way I will try to compare each and every scenario so that you can understand trigger well. So thank you for watching this video.